says. But the two homes right now sit on a 9.85 acre parcel, which is identified in your map that I provided. That is one parcel he could sell off by itself. He wouldn't have to sell the entire 33 acres to somebody. I'll let Jeff talk a little bit about concerns with the well and septic system.
The subdivision ordinance was created to promote the public health, safety, general welfare of the citizens of Washington County. Because we had a lot of people splitting and putting homes in bad areas or creating bad lots. And the minimum net lot area has to exclude the area below the 100-year flood elevation. This particular location, in subdivisions that have come to us before where that was the case, we actually elevated the entire lot, if the DNR allowed that to take place, to get it above the flood elevation. My suggestion back to this would be not to allow this property split. If there's any questions, I'll try to answer any of them.
Could you go ahead and give your full reason? I'm not sure I understand your reason not to allow it.
Well, in our rules, we stated that we were not going to allow any of that 54,000 square foot to be below the floodplain. This particular, both of these houses are completely below. Every last inch of the ground is below the floodplain. And my biggest concern is, it's just a swamp. And I'm afraid that if we let that develop or to exist, it just won't be a good thing for the health, safety, and welfare of the citizens of the county.
Thank you.
If you don't have any questions for us, I'll let public speak. I do have a letter that was faxed to me from one of the neighbors. Part of this process, I have to notify not only in the public notice and papers, but all landowners within 500 feet of the property. So one of the landowners, actually two of them, faxed me a letter this morning that I'll pass around.
So. Okay, I'd like to agree wholeheartedly with what this gentleman just said. I looked up all those parcels. Every single one of the four parcels is wholly within the 100-year floodplain. I have a question about, isn't a floodplain permit required before asking the county to issue any variance? Has it been determined that you don't need, for your particular proposal, you don't need a floodplain permit? Because that hasn't been issued.
Bill said earlier.
Or applied.
Oops.
So we'll answer that in just a second. Do you have anything else?
Yeah, I have a question regarding the, just a procedural question.
Okay.
The notice I read was in the Kelowna News. It gave no location. I wondered what other kind of public notice was given. You said you sent letters to adjacent landowners. Is that it?
Adjacent landowners. It was posted in the courthouse.
Sign put on the property or anything like that?
No, that's not a requirement of the ordinance.
Okay. It seems to me, that back to the non-procedural issues, it seems to me an extremely bad precedent to set to issue a variance for land that is 100% in the 100-year floodplain. There was a recent, I mean, just to give an example of a problem, that occurs with a development in, not even similar, but much better situated to a 100-year floodplain was what happened with the Timberline Estates subdivision in outside Riverside last year. And they were, to contrast the situation of Timberline Estates with this is 100% in the 100-year floodplain. Timberline Estates, sort of, its edge is in the 100-year floodplain. And there were 10 houses with, it was reported, 4 to 5 inches of water in the basement, have a different kind of road, access road, but their road was, became virtually impassable. It just a very, very, in my opinion, a very poor precedent to set, and particularly given a variance to an ordinance that's designed to protect the health and well-being of the citizens of Washington. Also, I might say the fiscal health and well-being of the taxpayers of Washington County. I would also like to note that out on the web there is a graphic which shows the blow up of that area of the floodplain with all four parcels that Mr. Young owns outlined in red to demonstrate it is wholly contained within the 100-year floodplain. And I can give you that web address. I also have it on a CD if you have computer access here. I thought perhaps I might get a computer.
Yeah, I believe that would be the same thing as this.
Well, I've got it. I've got his property overlaid on the floodplain map.
Okay.
You know, and it's the web address is shucks, it's shucks.com/WRDSmallE/V(1X.jpg).
Dot what?
JPG. It's just a standalone graphic out there. I can link it to my website if I want to, but I haven't thus far. There is also in that, I also put a, to contrast, a graphic of the Timberline development to show how the problems they had last September, when they are much better situated with regard to the 100-year floodplain, and that's in the, it's the same thing, only it's WRYTIMBERLINE.JPG. That I didn't outline, the Timberline Estates property, but you can see the development there, and you can see how it's just the southern edge of that development that borders on the, it's slightly within the 100-year floodplain.
Okay, I'll pass around a letter from Marvin Kalisic and Kay Harlan. Attend here, but he called me the other day, asked information about what was the variance was about. I asked if I could pass his concerns on. I said, well, I can't pass your verbal concerns on. I need something in writing or a person. So I wrote this and faxed it this morning. With that, I think I'll let Mr. Ritter and Mr. Young respond to anything they want or add anything.
Yeah. I'm not planning on changing anything that's not already there. I'm not planning on asking for any assistance from any taxpayer. I'm willing to invest a substantial amount of money to bring the septic system to the existing house up to standard that I'm not required to do if nothing, if this application is denied. Did I understand that I could sell both houses as one parcel?
Yeah, it's on an existing 9-acre parcel.
I guess what I'm asking is, I'm not asking to go build a new subdivision in a floodplain. I would not do that.